Denver 8 TV, your city, your source.
D-Town's going to the dogs!
And the cats. No worries, it's all good. Actually, it's great.
It's 8 great things to do with your pets.
You can take your pooch to the pool, have dinner and drinks with your dog, take your terrier to town, let Rover run free, get a pedicure with your pedigree, go shopping with your short hair, find a friend for Fido, and have fun with your feline.
Hey, Denver. Toby here. Just finishing that good treat that Rachel West gave me. She's out with her dog and cat friends. Okay, places to go, animals to see. So let's get right to it. Pets rule, dude.
Nothing like a dip in the pool on a hot day. Dogs love swimming. And one place to do that is right here at Earth Dog.
This doggy daycare center has a very cool outdoor pool complete with a waterfall. Dog daycare lets you drop off your canine companions while you're at work, for instance. This gives them a great opportunity to get back to their roots as pack animals. Plus, check with Earth Dog Denver for special events, like small dog meetups and open swims for the Baker, Washington Park, and Capitol Hill neighborhoods. Another fantastic pool in town is at Canine Fitness and Fun Center. It's also a daycare center, but on Sundays, it's Stay and Play, featuring open swims for any dog who joins up. Your dog just has to be evaluated for temperament to make sure everybody stays happy and healthy. And vaccinations need to be verified. Swimming is not only great for exercise and fun, but is very beneficial for certain ailments like arthritis and stroke and accident recovery. They've had some amazing results. Oh, wait, safety first. First-time swimmers will be fitted with a doggy life vest and monitored with individual attention. How cute is that? You can schedule a one-on-one session for any beginning swimmer or dog who needs some extra attention. You can even go in the water with your dog for a private session. How's that for puppy love? Plus, Stay and Play at Canine Fitness and Fun Center features some other super cool activities. So even if your dog doesn't like the pool, there's plenty of fun on dry land too. Or with a possible occasional sprinkle, that is.
Another awesome event, once a year, Denver Parks and Recreation hosts a dog-up pool-looza. Once the pool closes to people, you can take your dog for a dip at 2 of Denver's cool pools.
Yep, Berkeley Park and Cook Park swimming pools transform from people pools to doggy pools for one special day. Check the Denver.gov website for the yearly event, usually in August. Swimming is excellent exercise. 5 minutes of swimming is equivalent to 20 minutes of walking. So, let the fun begin. It's quiz time. According to Animal Planet, which of these dog breeds are not good candidates for swimming? Golden Retrievers, Irish Setters, or Bulldogs? The answer, because of their shorter legs and flat noses, breeds like Bulldogs might not be as successful in the water. But then again, that's why there are those adorable doggy life vests. Let the dogs out. Denver did. In authorized off-leash dog parks, that is. According to a recent article from the Trust for Public Land, quote, the hottest new city park issue to hit America is the skyrocketing support for creating places to let dogs run free, end quote. Oh yes, we're way ahead of you. The city currently has 10 outdoor off-leash dog parks for your enjoyment, where your best friends can strut their stuff. Dogs love to run, and these enclosed areas give them the space to exercise and socialize with their canine compadres. Yeah, dogs need a social life too. And according to dogchannel.com, having a place to run free can even help reduce barking and other problem behaviors. Denver's dog parks are open from sunrise to sundown 7 days a week. Your pup must be spayed or neutered or have a current Denver intact permit. And they've got to have a current rabies and dog license. Please follow all rules and regulations. Oh, and there are doggy waste bags for your convenience. Rules out of the way? Okay, time to run free. What percentage of U.S. households have at least one dog, according to the Humane Society? 38%, 47%, or 61%? The answer, the percentage of U.S. households with a dog, 47%.
Now, you probably don't want to take your cat all over town with you, but there's plenty that you can do right at home with your cat. Did you know that spending even 15 minutes a day with your cat can make them so much happier and healthier? And it might even make you happier and healthier. We're here at the Denver Animal Shelter to find out a little bit more. Aww.
We met up with Big Boy and Jen for some Kitty Play 101.
One of the primary toys that we're using in the shelter right now on a regular basis for all the cats are what we call Kongs, and the Kong Company, that's a local company, makes these. These are specifically for cats. And you can see he's waiting for me to dispense this, so I'm going to keep him out of his agony here.
So this is something you put in the middle here?
Yes, they're hollow. What we use for the cats is a paste that's salmon flavored, fish flavored. The cats like that. We put just a real small amount on the inside, and the idea is they have to work to get it out, so it keeps their brain engaged. It's a puzzle for them. And Big Boy in particular is enamored with his Kongs. You can see.
It's his salmon Kong puzzle.
It's his salmon Kong puzzle. It keeps them challenged for longer than just putting a boring bowl of food out in front of them. Not meant to be a meal replacer, just something to add to their day to keep them engaged, give them something fun to do. And there are lots of other toys out there and things that you can do at home. Things like cat grass, which I know you can buy at many pet stores now. Things like putting different scents around your house for them
really?
To smell. And playing, especially if you have indoor cats, playing music for them that might have like some bird songs intermixed in there. So you're enriching them in an auditory sense as well. And other more traditional toys that we do use in the shelter, things like cat charmers.
So you're really talking about stimulating your cat on a daily basis in terms of all senses then?
Right, especially more and more people having indoor cats. Yeah. How do you create an environment inside for them that would keep them as mentally engaged and physically challenged as they would have access to if they were outside? And it is completely possible to do that.
It's also very important to provide cats with a dedicated scratching post. If you can, it's awesome to give your cat a safe outdoor experience with a fully screened-in patio or a cat sanctuary, fully enclosed from top to bottom, complete with their own kitty door for maximum freedom.
All right, Jen, we went from Big Boy to these little cuties. Who do we have?
Cuties, this is Rascal right here that you're playing with, and Missy over here.
Oh my gosh, they're so adorable. Now this is probably an example of learning how to stimulate your kitten's energy. So how do you keep your kittens ready to go throughout the day and so that they have something to do?
And kittens have no shortage of energy, so it's more about how do we channel it appropriately.
Hi.
Like
oh,
there.
Yes. You'd rather play with my hair?
So that's a perfect example though, right? Kittens are gonna play with whatever they find and how we can direct their
yes.
play onto things
exactly.
that we'd rather have them play with. There we go. Getting them to direct their play energy onto toys that are appropriate, and that if they bite them, no harm
it's
done,
fine, yeah.
right? If you could commit to interactive play, so meaning between you and your cat, twice a day, 15 minutes each time, which isn't too much to ask. If you figure 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the evening, most people can accommodate that. The rest of the day, they can find ways to entertain themselves, and kittens will always find ways of entertaining themselves. But that way, you're directing play onto toys, and you're part of the process. And doing that on a regular interval is also really helpful for the cats too. That way they can expect when it's gonna happen and anticipate it, and then are less likely to annoy you to play with them at times you don't want, like the middle of the night.
Right.
If they know when that interactive time is gonna happen with you, you can prevent some of those kinds of problems. These are, you know, highly interactive. Then there are toys that are more standalone varieties that you can leave out for them to find on their own when you don't have time to interact with them, like this guy. And this one makes noises. See if it will fit here. little bird chirping noises.
And that's something that can occupy your kitten while you're away if you can't be there with them for
right.
the whole day.
Right. We've talked about the cat kongs and the little interactive treat balls that the treats can fall out of. Those are also things you can leave for them when you're not around. If you leave them scattered in places around the house that they might frequent when you're not home, and then they can kind of keep finding them all day long, those are good ways to keep their energy directed on the things that you're happy to have them play with, you know, instead of your curtains.
Exactly. Rascal approved.
Okay, more from the Denver Animal Shelter later in our show. That and much more when we return. On a beautiful summer morning, shopping for fresh produce with your pooch. What could be better? Yes, one fun place to take your canine companion is the farmer's market. There are several wonderful weekly farmer's markets in Denver, like this one, the City Park Esplanade Fresh Market. On Sunday mornings from June through November, this place comes alive with fresh produce and booths for Colorado agricultural products, including baked goods, freshly prepared foods, and gourmet products. It's the Cadillac of farmers markets, according to Colorado Biz Magazine. These Colorado fresh markets have been operating since 1997. They have chef demonstrations, kitchen and garden products, gardening tips from master gardeners, plus live music and more in a fun and festive open-air shopping environment. They even track the fresh produce for you so you can plan your summer and fall around the most in-season products. There are also fresh markets in Stapleton on Sundays and Cherry Creek on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Plus, there are several other farmers markets around town too. And of course, dogs on leashes are welcome here. Water bowls and treats help keep your canine happy. Not to mention just being able to come out with mom or dad to a cool dog-friendly event. There are certainly some fun smells around a farmer's market. So how much keener is a dog's sense of smell than a human's? 10 times? 100 times? Or thousands of times? The answer? Well, reports vary, but most experts agree it's thousands of times better than a human's. Some dog experts claim it's millions of times better.
Dinner, drinks, and dogs. You can find it all here at the Watering Bowl. Let's go check it out.
All right, we find ourselves hanging out at the Watering Bowl with Justin. You've got a pretty cool place here.
Thank you.
What is this all about? You can bring your dogs and the dogs are hanging out. What's the whole concept?
The concept is it's your backyard just better. You can come be part of our family. Think of your normal place you go once or twice a month. Here you come to on a daily basis because it is your friends. It's cold, great beer from local distilleries. It's amazing food. We have a full kitchen. We'll have the UFC fights. We have parties, birthdays, anniversaries.
We have
a little wrestling match going on now. So it is the place to go.
What do you offer for the dogs? Can they order things as well?
You know, they can. We do have dog treats that we make in-house. However, they just want to play and have a good time. It's the owners that want to have a beer and some food and just enjoy themselves.
So do you have the regular canine clientele?
We absolutely do. We'll recognize the dogs before we do the people.
They seem to really be enjoying it. You've got such a great setting for them here, too. What other things do you offer for clients who bring their dogs in?
Well, here, we're the cleanest, most hygienic facility in Denver. We are AstroTurf that gets washed every day, sanitized. So even on bad weather days, we're the cleanest place in town.
Wow, that's nice. The dogs seem to be having a good time back there.
Absolutely, they always do.
They're bringing everybody together. Is it true you offer really cool events for dogs, too, catering to them, like birthdays?
We've had numerous dog weddings, dog bar mitzvahs, anniversaries, birthday parties on a weekly basis, and those can range from their owners having drinks to full cakes and costumes and hats, and some of the Denver owners can get a little extravagant.
Hey now, Dtown, we love our dogs.
Absolutely.
And so this is really a great place for everybody in Dtown to come and enjoy the social network that you've put together and this wonderful backyard feel. What's inside like?
Inside, it's a lodge. Inside, we have a 26 and a 19-foot jumbo TVs. We have pool tables, lounges, a punching bag game, darts, two bars, full service restaurant. It is your neighborhood bar on steroids.
No kidding, this is the place to come along with your dog in Dtown. You got it all.
Absolutely, and even outside, we have a heated covered enclosure for the wintertime.
Really, wow. Now, is it true that you have plans to expand here soon?
We have. We have opened up negotiations with other potential partners and municipalities, but we are looking to expand it on four locations in the next 16 months.
And will they all have the same ability to bring your dog into the backyard area?
Yes.
Meanwhile, you know, we're sipping a brew and they're just having fun wrestling. This is the place to be.
And that's the concept. Just come have a good time like your backyard with friends you've never met.
Thanks to Justin and everybody at Watering Bowl. We'll be right back with much more.
Ah, nothing like pampering yourself, especially when you can bring your dog along. Don't have a dog? No worries. Because here at File and Style, they usually have at least one or two to help keep you entertained. Good job. What do you think, Lazy? We are living the life.
Yes, the friendly dogs at File and Style love to cozy up to the patrons, or you can bring your own in. File and Style is a unique urban chic boutique and nail spa centrally located in one of the city's oldest neighborhoods. Your feet will love the fresh floating flowers in a resin bowl. Did you know this kind of bowl is the safest, healthiest option for a pedicure? Yeah, who knew? Sanitation is their number one priority, by the way. Years of experience for the manicurists ensure a safe experience. Yep, these ladies are filing and styling and smiling. And it's the best of both worlds, pampering and shopping, with an awesome array of clothing, jewelry, and accessories. File and Style even has some special events like the yearly Valentine's fundraiser, Pretty Paws for a Cause. This fun event helps big dogs huge paws for rescue, rehabilitation, and resources.
Oh, now you and your doggie can hit the town in style, courtesy of File and Style. You ready, Lacey? Yeah.
One large dog breed is the St. Bernard. Male St. Bernards can often weigh close to how many pounds? 100, 200, or 300? The answer, these lovable giants can often weigh almost 200 pounds.
So let's say you want to come downtown to stay overnight for New Year's, or maybe even restaurant week, or maybe you have some out-of-town guests. Either way, did you know that you can bring your pet along to some really cool hotels, including Hotel Monaco?
This wonderful hotel in the heart of downtown has a bold style and a vibrant atmosphere. It's the Denver Pet-Friendly Hotel.
Really a pet-friendly hotel. Good to see.
To keep your loyal companion happy and healthy while traveling, they offer some very fetching amenities, like food and water bowls and a dog bed placed in the room. And treats. Gotta have those treats.
Beware. Dog at play inside.
Creature comforts are important, so Hotel Monaco makes sure to extend a friendly paw to your four-legged friends when you stay there. They welcome all kinds of pets in addition to dogs, without size or weight restrictions. And there's no extra charge or deposit.
And hey, look at this. If you don't have a pet of your own, they'll even bring you one for the night. Look at this guy. You're super cute. How great is it to have pet-friendly hotels in downtown Denver? Way to go, Dtown. Lacey thanks you too. So comfy.
Yeah, it is. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so our dog Lacey is a Maltese Fox Terrier. According to MalteseManiac.com, which of these aristocrats owned a Maltese? Alexander the Great, Roman Emperor Claudius, or Peter the Great? The answer, along with such leaders as Queen Elizabeth I, Roman Emperor Claudius owned a Maltese. And now it might just be time to find a friend for Fido. Let's go back to the Denver Animal Shelter to learn more.
All right, here we are outside the Denver Animal Shelter. Andy, nice to see you.
Yeah.
Thanks for having us here. So the first thing you notice when you come up to the shelter, of course, is this wonderful art piece, Sunspot, right?
Correct, Sunspot.
Tell us about Sunspot.
Absolutely. Sunspot was commissioned along with the building back when we opened in June of 2009. He was designed by a couple of artists out of Washington, the state of Washington,
really?
That won the bid process to create our art piece here at the shelter, and Sunspot is their creation.
Sunspot is cute and beautiful at the same time, a perfect meld of art. What's he made of?
He's a steel skeletal structure. He's about 25 feet tall. He actually had to be assembled on site because of his sheer size. He is covered in stainless steel dog tags.
Okay, so I guess the question of the day would be, how many are on there? Are you going to tell me?
How many do you think are on there?
How many do I? How did I know he was going to ask me to count? Let me do some quick calculations. Carry the one, multiply by pi. 2,000.
You're going to have to go up a little bit. Give it one more shot. Think bigger.
25,000.
He's actually covered in 90,000 stainless steel dog tags.
Oh my gosh, 90,000.
90,000.
That's incredible. Sunspot, you have our undying respect. That is incredible. And it really goes with the whole facility. It's an eye-catching facility. It's something special.
Absolutely, yeah. When they've seen the big silver dog, they know they're at the Denver Animal Shelter.
Well, why don't we head inside and take a look at what you guys have going on in there?
All right, will do.
Let's go. All right, we're hanging out inside the shelter. Who do we have here?
We've got Naomi. She's a one-year-old boxer mix, and she's available for adoption.
Oh, she's so adorable. So there's a lot to learn about the shelter in terms of how the community can interact here. So what happens if we have a lost or found dog?
So as the municipal shelter for the city and county of Denver, we do all of the stray dog intake for the city. So we have officers that respond to calls for stray animals running loose. Also, people can bring stray animals that they found here to the shelter. Whether it's during business hours or after hours, we do have a night drop area where people can drop off, securely place the animal in a night drop overnight, where it will be safe until morning and can be processed.
So the community can really look to the Denver Animal Shelter as their resource, and the animal protection officers as well if we see an issue that we need help with.
Absolutely, we're here to serve the community.
So especially for our dogs like Naomi, all sizes and breeds, what are some tips for this hot weather?
Yeah, during the summer months is really dangerous for animals. One of the calls that we get most frequently is for animals left in hot vehicles. On a day where it's only 70 degrees, that doesn't seem like much to us. Inside of a vehicle, after only 10 minutes, the interior temperature can get upwards of 90 degrees, even with the windows cracked, so that doesn't really help. On hotter days, it gets worse, and the longer the animal's in the vehicle, the worse it gets. So it's really important that we don't leave our animals in the vehicle. It can ultimately lead to internal damage to their organs and potentially death.
So the message there is just don't leave your dog alone in the car.
Absolutely. If you're heading out somewhere and you have to make a stop and the dog can't go with you, just plan on leaving your dog at home for that trip.
Exactly. And the same probably goes for the hot asphalt, in the middle of the day, the dog's with their paws. How's that in hot weather?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, asphalt, if you've ever walked barefoot on it yourself in the middle of the summer, it's terribly hot. It could be the same for them. So if you're going to be getting them out and getting them their walks daily, do it in the morning or in the evening just to make it a little easier on them.
Yeah. We want you to be comfortable, Naomi. So how does the adoption work from the shelter?
You come to the shelter, we'll do a visit between you and the animal. If you do have other pets at home, we have you bring your other dog in as well, and we'll do a meet and greet between the animals. We do that to try to ensure that it's going to be a good fit, not just for you and your family, but also for your other pets at home.
So you really help facilitate the full process, even moving into a new home with other animals.
We do, yeah. We really want to make sure that it's a good fit and that the animal that you're adopting is going to be perfect for your family, your lifestyle, and your other pets at home.
Well, I might just have to check out the selection.
Right.
See what little doggy or kitty soul I could find.
Before I continue my search for a new friend, how about a little behind-the-scenes action? Did you know Denver Animal Shelter has a barn?
Well, Andy has promised. This must be the barn.
It is.
Tell us about it. What do we have here?
So this is kind of unique to us here because we didn't have this at our older facility. As you can hear, we've got a couple of roosters here that are staying with us temporarily. In Denver, we do have some working farms around the area, so we occasionally do get farm animals. You can also have chickens, ducks, and pygmy goats with a food-producing animal permit here in Denver. Other farm-type animals you can't have in Denver without a livestock permit, which also has to go through zoning. So people that have had their farms here in Denver for quite a while are kind of grandfathered in because Denver is so population dense, it's a lot tougher to get these little working farms up and running here in Denver. A lot of times because your neighbors don't want to hear this.
Yeah. So I would imagine someone had these roosters and their neighbor might not have appreciated
them. Most likely. That was probably the case with these fellas.
So what happens to the roosters here? You'll care for them and then will they get adopted out?
We won't directly adopt them out of the shelter here. We work with a lot of rescue partners and some of those are working farms. And so we'll transfer them to their facilities and some of them do adopt them themselves. Some of them will keep them there on the farm too.
Nice. Very nice. So what other types of animals have you seen come through the barn?
We've seen a miniature pony. We've had a pot-bellied pig. We've had a full-size goat. We get chickens and roosters, so we get kind of a good variety.
So what are the other unique animals that you come to inside the shelter?
We get all sorts of things here at the facility, mostly dogs and cats, but we do get small mammals like rabbits, hamsters, guinea pigs, gerbils, rats, mice.
And fish.
We do get fish occasionally as well. We also get birds, reptiles like snakes and turtles, ferrets. We get all sorts of things, so we get quite the variety. People can check us out on our website at denveranimalshelter.org, and all the animals that are available for adoption are right there online where they can check out pictures and details so they can see before they even come in to visit us.
Well, I don't know about you, but I think Dtown should be proud of the Denver Animal Shelter. You guys are doing good work.
I think all of Denver should be proud of it. We're lucky to have the support of the citizens for this building.
Well, I'm proud of it. I'm proud of that rooster back there. So, Andy, I think I might go looking around to see if I could find a little doggy friend for my doggy. What do you say?
Great. I bet we can find you one.
Let's go see what we can find. Well, hello.
Inside, I found this little sweetie, Roger.
Well, hello, Roger. Hi, sweetheart.
Once you find that new potential best friend, it's time for formal introductions.
Okay, let's go say hi to Roger. Come on, let's go.
The Denver Animal Shelter will set up a meet and greet to let your dog and the prospective new dog get acquainted before you actually take your new family member home. It helps ensure you find the perfect match and assists the animal with the transition into a new environment.
I don't know about you, but I'd say we found a match. Mwah. Mwah.
Kitties and puppies. You know, it doesn't get much better than that. So I think we're gonna have to take another look. Here's the recap.
Here are 8 great things you can do with your pet. How about a dip in the pool for your pooch? There are some fun places including Earth Dog Denver and Canine Fitness and Fun Center. Plus, once a year, Denver's Parks and Recreation lets dogs swim in a couple of the city's pools for Dog-a-Pool-ooza. Going to stay downtown for a special occasion or have out-of-town friends coming in? Hotel Monaco is a fantastic pet-friendly hotel that caters to your canines and felines, and most every other kind of pet you can have. Need a manny or a petty? File and Style lets you bring your dog in with you. Or they usually have a dog or two to keep you company while you pamper yourself. And you can fit in some shopping while you're there with some very stylish selections. Dinner, drinks, dogs. Watering Bowl has a large outdoor dog run. You can eat, drink, and socialize, and so can your dogs. You can even arrange a birthday party for your pooch or a wedding for a happy canine couple. Okay, yeah, I know what you're thinking, but the kids love it. Let your pup run free at one of several off-leash dog parks in Denver. Great for exercising and socializing for your four-legged friends, and maybe you too. And letting your dog run free may even help with barking or other behavioral problems. Shopping more your style? There are some wonderful farmers markets like City Park Esplanade Fresh Market. Your dog can keep you company while you shop for some fresh produce and other appetizing foods in a fun and entertaining environment. How about finding a new friend for your best friend? Denver Animal Shelter is a wonderful place to do just that, with special meet and greets so your dog can meet a prospective new dog before you ever take it home. And of course, you can also bring home a loving feline too. And let's not forget that our kitty companions need mental and physical stimulation too. There are lots of fun toys for your cat, and spending just a few minutes playing with them every day will help make them happier and healthier.
Do you have suggestions for more fun things to do with your pet? Or maybe we've enticed you to come visit some of these great places that we've seen on our show. Either way, we want to see your great pics from some of the places that we visited on our show today. I'm going to be looking for them. Yeah, go get it.
Also, show us your adorable adopted pets from the Denver Animal Shelter or other rescue groups or shelters. Post them on our Facebook page at I Love Dtown or email us at dtown@denvergov.org. While you're at it, be sure to check out our YouTube page.
All right, we can't wait to see your pooch pics and your kitty pics. In the meantime, I think I'm going to hang out with my new friends, both of the human and canine variety. You ready? Let's do this. Go get it. See you next time. Yeah, good job.